I'm fascinated by glaciers because I think they are magnificent features in the landscape. They have been here thousands of years before I came to this place, so they give me a wider sense of time. It's sad to see them disappearing, but I also feel that when you work with the glaciers, you have to put emotions aside, then I will make much better decisions, I will conduct much better research than if I was thinking I'm at the place of crisis. My name is Nina Kirchner and I'm director of Tarfala Research Station. The most transformative moment for me was when I realized that I could use the knowledge that I had gained during my studies, I studied mathematics, that I could apply that to describe how a glacier moves. And that made me really stick to the glaciers and become a professional glaciologist. Tarfala Research Station is Stockholm University's Center for Glaciological and Alpine Research. We are located here in the Tarfala Valley in the Kebnekaise Mountains in northern Sweden, just above the Arctic Circle. In these environments, climate change is already accelerating, so we are basically situated in a natural laboratory where we can observe processes that will occur later at other places in the world already now.
My name is Rory White and I'm from the University of Sheffield. Here is such a great place to study just because you have three glaciers on your doorstep really. And I think it's one of the few places in the world where you can be in a nice warm room, have a nice warm meal.
Allihopa, nu börjar det dags för mat, så varsågoda och kom och ta för dig.
And half an hour later, you can be on the ice surface and on a glacier, which I think is super impressive.
Glaciology has quite a long history of research because people have always been interested in ice. It's something special, it's kind of fascinating. People might ask, yeah, but what is there still to find out after so many years of research? But actually, I think we're just at the beginning of understanding all the processes that are going on.
Storglaciären, which is located about 1 kilometer from Tarfala Research Station, is quite unique because we have the longest detailed mass balance series in the world for this glacier, so more than 70 years of continuous measurements telling us how the glacier is behaving, whether it's growing or shrinking. We have established a measurement system called the traditional glaciological method. It means we have stakes on the glacier that we drill into the glacier to be able to measure changes in glacier surface elevation. And we go there regularly and check whether the glacier has gained mass, ice that is, or lost mass.
So then, 3 days ago, it was like here, yeah. And now we have lost 20 centimeters in 3 days.
At the end of a year, we report that to an international database in Switzerland, the World Glacier Monitoring Service. At that database, glacier data from around the world is collected. And to summarize it shortly, we see the same trends for all glaciers in the world. They are reducing, and this is because of we have a climate warming.
The thing I've enjoyed the most so far is just definitely being on the glacier. It's a surreal experience when you're there, and especially where I'm from, it's super loud, super busy with car traffic and sirens all the time, and then you're just stood on the glacier in the middle of nowhere, and all you can hear is just water running in the wind, and it's such a nice feeling.
On one of our recent excursions to Stora Glaciären, we found many of these new moulins that now, with all these increased meltwater masses, appear on the glacier where we haven't been seeing them before. I find it more and more interesting to even think of that part in the glacier system. Where is all the surface meltwater going? That is very interesting, both from a scientific point of view, but also it's important and relevant for our safety, because when these new features open and give us a straight connection from the glacier surface to the bed, it's a very different spot to be on.
This is like where all the meltwater will go down. So we stay away from it. There is a lot of those here in the area. They used to be higher up. This one we haven't seen before, so we will mark it on the map.
It is so many disciplines that connect to the same feature, the glacier. It is the glaciologist, it's the hydrologist, it's probably someone looking at the bedrock beneath it. So it's a whole research group discipline opening up where we need people to collaborate to find out what processes are actually going on. Working in an environment like this is usually very, very challenging. If you are in a remote environment like this, where you cannot arrive by car, where you cannot do your food shopping, where you don't have access to basic services, then any field operation is getting very, very complicated. Sometimes a helicopter cannot land because of fog or because of wind. So we are very happy that we have an entire station with all facilities here that allows us to work in the field and still have a relatively convenient infrastructure here in the place.
I think we can börja med frukostgrejerna.
We are running the station with a crew of six. We need to complement each other. We need our different expertise to make this station a great workplace. We usually check the weather every hour and if needed more often. Our routines for being prepared for this rapidly changing environment is that we make a plan in the evening of the day, and we make plane A, B, C, D, E, and F. And in the morning at breakfast, when we gather together with the crew, we revise these plans according to the weather. And it may turn out that only plan F or G or H is working because of the weather. So we need to be flexible all the time to respond to these rapidly changing conditions that we have here. All the data that we collect here at the research station is made publicly available in something that is called an open access database. It means everyone can have access to it. And in that sense, we multiply the value of this data because it's used by many more people from everywhere that probably have a totally different angle studying the data than we or my colleagues would have had. Lake Tarfala has literally been for a long time in the shadow of Kebnekaise and Stora Glaciären. But we got interested in the lake a couple of years ago and we started by measuring its temperature. And of course, with climate warming, we expected that the temperatures in the lake would have been higher than in the 60s. And we have several measurements from the 1960s. But when we measured a surprising result was that the temperatures had not risen, and we were first puzzled by that. And the answer when you have the solution in your hand is very easy. The lake is colder because the summer has been so hot that the glaciers have been melting, cooling down the lake for a short instance of time in the lifetime of the lake and the environment. So understanding climate change requires you to look at the broader picture to see how things are interconnected.
It's human nature, really, to try and understand more and to find things that we don't know. And I think that's why a lot of explorers from years past, they came to places like Tarfala and they went and measured the glaciers, because it's like, why are these things happening? I think it's innately human nature to try and understand and unpick pieces of nature that we don't understand. It's super important as humans that's what we do. I think that's how humans act, is we want to understand what's going on in the world around us.
I think that we as people are capable of making drastic changes once we have understood the importance of making these changes. And Tarfala Research Station is a wonderful meeting place where just this can be accomplished, and where we can collect knowledge from a vast range of disciplines to understand this environment much better than we do now. Thank you.